Welcome to your guide to Royal Core and its subcategories and similar aesthetics. In this video, I'll be going through the origin, inspiration, fashion, and subgenres of Royal Core. This includes King Core, Queen Core, Princess Core, Prince Core, and Regency Core. I will not be going through Knight Core and Ranger Core in this video, but let me know if you'd like to make a separate video on them. As for Royal Academia, I have already talked about it in my previous Academia video, so if you want to know more about it, make sure to check out that video. And as usual, I will be providing alternatives to non-binary people as well as conservative alternatives for some clothing. If you clicked on this video without knowing what your aesthetic is, make sure to check out my Aesthetics 2021 video and my other aesthetic guides first, so you can find out what your aesthetic is. Now let us begin. So what is Royal Core? Royal Core refers to a group of aesthetics based on the visuals and elements of West European royalty. The main elements of Royal Core consist of intelligence, morality, various kinds of skills, and an ever-present elegance. The visual elements include castle structures and architecture, including a curiosity for its related subcategories, such as royal gardens and knight training. You may recognize some of the names for the historic inspiration, such as the Tudors, the Medicis, and the Windsor family. Royal Core's historical focus ranges from the 5th and 6th century Arthurian times to the 16th century Tudor period, so there is a lot to work with if you want to look for different sources of inspiration. If I had to explain what Royal Core is about, I would ask you to visualize princesses and princes, and kings and queens, and how these people would act and dress. Unlike cottagecore, Royal Core works more like a time capsule, both in terms of fashion and lifestyle. The corsets and long gowns carried themselves over to our modern day lives, whereas cottagecore has always remained present despite its history. I haven't seen many people take this aesthetic to its full glory yet, but as I predicted in my 2021 aesthetics video, people certainly have started to dress in more formal styles, even for casual days. Since we are slowly seeing some hope at the end of the tunnel with COVID-19, there is something exciting about getting ready to show the world your best looks every single day and to make up for the lost time. As the popularity of royal and vintage aesthetics keep rising, designers like Deota Matoshi keep gaining more popularity. Most people tend to take away certain elements from these aesthetics, such as corsets, and style them with modern pieces, whereas some prefer to dress more accurately to the time period of their interest. So let's talk more about the history where these aesthetics stem from. Starting with the period of King Arthur, a British king in the 5th and 6th century, of whom there are many folklore stories about. King Arthur has inspired many books, shows, and movies, such as Merlin, The Sword in the Stone, Quest for Camelot, and even the third Shrek movie. During this time period, the Knights of the Round Table and other royal security would wear hauberks, the chainmail shirts to protect themselves, and other armor such as gauntlets. The royal family would dress in long cloaks and gowns, often wearing luxurious garments. Sumptuary laws, which regulated and reinforced social hierarchies and morals, usually dictated who got to wear what. Since the Arthurian period was known for its mystery and romance tales, this period has inspired many, both in terms of fashion and storytelling. I won't get into all the historical details of the periods between the 6th and the 16th in this video, but feel free to do more research on a time period of your preference. Skipping to the infamous Medici and Tudor era in the Renaissance period, we bring ourselves to the fabulous fashion of the royal courts. Fashion began peaking in the 1400s, and during this time the dress code for women was to wear a high-waisted dress on top of a smock dress, often with the option of detachable sleeves. The outfit was finished with an empire waist overdress that would be split to two sides and belted down. Men wore padded doublets and a codpiece, what would in modern times look similar to leggings. This outfit would be topped with a cape that was often a different color on the outside and inside. Heels and flats were common shoes to wear in this era. As for accessorizing, women parted their hair at the center and would add ribbons or netting as accessories. They could add sheer hairnets to the backs of their heads, and sometimes these hairnets were also beaded. Finally, there are leather cords that were often bejeweled and worn around the head. The slash and puff style was also popular, where a garment's outer part was slashed and the inner garment would be pulled through and puffed out, so to speak. With the color palette, the earth tones ruled in this era, with some exceptional light hues like light blue or maximalist colors like crimson red. The 1500s were an era of go big or go home. Almost like modern maximalism, the dresses became very big and puffy, Big skirts, blouses, and other garments were in fashion and used almost as a status symbol. Ruching off the sleeves became popular, making the sleeves puffier. The Medici and Tudor families especially took all of these styles and went all out with them, which resulted in dramatic collars as well as luxurious and huge dresses. Even the French court and Mary Queen of Scots were seen rocking these styles. There are various other details that I will not get into in this video, but feel free to watch the history videos and sources I've linked below if you want to do more research. For royal court inspiration, you can watch some perhaps not quite historically accurate shows and movies like Elizabeth, Ever After, A Cinderella Story, Lady Jane, Rain, Medici the Magnificent, The Tudors, and Mary Queen of Scots. For books, read something like The Birth of Venus, The Last Queen, The Other Boyland Girl, Wolf Hall, and White Queen. The color palette of royal court consists of several earthy and rich tones, such as gold, silver, and different shades of reds, blues, and whites. For fashion, you can choose a more modern or classical route in terms of mixing and matching clothes for this aesthetic. Because royal court as an aesthetic is fairly new, there are not yet big distinctions on how formal or informal your stylistic experimentation can be, but like I always say, these are guides, not rule books, so feel free to test out different looks. Get yourself that fancy dress you've had bookmarked in your browser for months now, and invest in a corset or two, and test out the waters with different types of gloves or skirts if you'd like. Go all out with the maximalist examples of the Medicis, or tone it down with a few statement pieces that tie into a more modern outfit. Royal court is like art, and you are the artist, so feel free to experiment. A few pieces you should consider investing in are puffy or ruched dresses, a few corsets or stays of different colors, some fancy sheer balloon sleeve blouses or embroidered blouses. Pair a fancy blouse with cropped pants or Renaissance-inspired gothic pants for a more masculine or non-binary appearance. For textures and material, consider high-quality fabrics like silk, velvet, taffeta, wool, and fur. Accessorize with statement jewelry pieces like diamonds or pearls, and some sheer beaded hairnets or crowns and tiaras. Wear some heels or tidy flats to go along with your outfits, and pin your hair half up or braided or in a beautiful bun. Again, considering the wide range of inspiration, you can feel free to experiment with different hairstyles. For my hijab-wearing friends, add a few gold or jeweled pins on the sides of your hijab, or even a jeweled headband for a more elevated look, or opt for a hijab in the color palette of royal court. And if you are seeking for a more conservative outfit, consider layering a blouse underneath a smock dress, or opt for a long sleeve dress or a top with a boat neck, turtleneck, or high neckline. For makeup, again, stick to earthy tones. Nothing too much, but a little bit of something is good to have. For example, using shades of brown and gold on your eyes, and a simple red lip would look elegant and effortless. Feel free to experiment a little bit more if you're going for a modernized version. Now that we've explored royal court, let's move on to its subcategories and similar aesthetics. All of these aesthetics have their own specific styles and guidelines. Let us begin. King court and queen court. King court and queen court are variants of royal court that revolve around the imagery of power of portrayed kings and queens in history, themes of politics, war, and hierarchy. These subcategories have a heavy focus on the elements of power mixed with elegance. These aesthetics are heavily inspired by the kings and queens of the past, such as Francis I, Queen Elizabeth, Catherine the Great, Henry VIII, and Mary Queen of Scots. Both aesthetics consist of themes of strength and guidance, as well as skill and patience. Those who adopt these aesthetics may feel like they are well suited for leadership roles. For inspiration, turn to movies and shows like The Great, Victoria, The Crown, Mary Queen of Scots, Rain, Elizabeth, and many more. King court's color palette consists of gold, royal blue, black, white, purple, and red, whereas queen court's color palette centers around dark reds, deep purples, royal blue, emerald green, gold, silver, black, and white. For fashion, as usual, you can take direct inspiration from historical accounts or modernize these aesthetics. For a more modern version of king court, wear gray or black suits, white or black button-down shirts, ties, fitted slacks, and dress shoes. You could play with combining different court colors, maybe a navy blue blazer and a black button-down. Accessorize with a cloak and gloves if necessary, and add cufflinks and rings. Keep your hair looking tidy, either combed back or otherwise. If you want to go fancy, add in some fur, velvet, or other luxurious textures to elevate your outfit. For makeup, go light if adding any, focusing mostly on concealing imperfections unless you are modernizing this look. As for a modernized version of Queencore, you can actually use a lot of the same silhouettes from the past, such as floor-length formal wear, ball gowns, and such. To follow the example of more modern royalty, you can opt for wide-legged jumpsuits or modest-length day dresses within the color palette. Tailored blouses and fitted suits and blazer sets are great, as well as layered long coats and cloaks. Throw in a corset or a long dressing robe and spice it up. You can once again go with more luxurious textures if you want. Add some heeled footwear and a clutch bag. Accessorize with jeweled hair pieces or head pieces, gloves, rings, and gold, diamond, or pearl jewelry. If you feel fancy, add in a crown or tiara. Make sure your hair is always tidy and tied back or otherwise neat. If wearing a hijab, accessorize it with key colors of Queencore or choose a hijab within the color palette if you'd like. Like with Kingcore, keep the makeup of Queencore minimal. You can use the color palette as inspiration for some earthy tones for your eyeshadow, but the goal is to stay minimal unless you want to modernize it. Princecore and Princesscore. Princecore and Princesscore are both subgenres of Royalcore, with Princecore acting as the masculine counterpart to Princesscore's feminine qualities. The main elements of both aesthetics are similar to Royalcore, but you could view them as slightly more youthful versions of King and Queencore. Princecore is considered to be softer and more romantic than Kingcore, with more emphasis on the romanticization of princes and the fantasy love stories often written about them. Princesscore, on the other hand, has more emphasis on its fashion aspect, dressing and acting like a princess, and having the qualities of royalty. The color palettes of these aesthetics are slightly similar to Royalcore, with Princecore's colors being blue, gold, silver, green, and white, and Princesscore's being gold, silver, white, pink, and light blue. The fashion of Princecore and Princesscore is definitely more colorful. Princecore's fashion includes suits, jackets, button-ups or collared shirts, dressy pants or jeans depending on the occasion and whether or not you're modernizing this aesthetic, as well as either boots or polished shoes. Again, feel free to play with more luxurious textures and fabrics. As for Princesscore, opt for expensive fabrics like cashmere if you can, and feel free to experiment with light flowy dresses, ball gowns, corsets, and interesting necklines like the square or sweetheart neckline. If you don't want to wear a dress, you can opt for a flowy button-up shirt or a collared shirt with lace or embroidery added to it. Switch the long dress for a skirt or dress pants. For more conservative options, focus on the long sleeve dresses, blouses, and cloaks. Experiment with intricate patterns if you'd like. Accessorize with slightly more feminine or dainty jewelry, like hair bows, braided half-up and half-downs, pearl pins, pink or blue ribbons, and such. Add in a tiara if you'd like. Your hair can be slightly messier than it would be with other aesthetics, but do still try to maintain it with hair accessories or some hairdos if you'd like. If wearing a hijab, you can opt for one in the color palette of the subcategories or decorate it with pearl pins and other jeweled headwear. For both of these aesthetics, you can be a little bit more experimental with makeup. With Princecore, anything soft like autumnal or spring colors would work, whereas Princesscore works best with pastels, so stick with summer and spring-like tones such as peach, pink, and blue shades. Try to still keep your makeup a little more minimal than you would with an aesthetic like Fairycore. But again, feel free to experiment. Regencycore. There is no official guide to Regencycore yet, as it has only recently gained the attention of people with shows like Bridgerton becoming popular. To put it simply, Regencycore is an aesthetic focusing on the 18th century Regency era, which took place in the United Kingdom. This is the romantic era Jane Austen's books are based in, for example. Instead of focusing on the monarchs of this era, Regencycore focuses on the fashion, culture, and mannerisms derived from the Regency era. Ever since I was a kid, I have noticed this era being an age of romance to many of us who grew up reading Jane Austen's books and Sir Walter Scott's poems. And so it has always been around, but never so prominently as it is now. For inspiration, read any Jane Austen book and watch shows and movies like Bridgerton, Emma, Becoming Jane, and Death Comes to Pemberley. The Regency era's color palette is broad and more inclusive of different colors, including different shades of green, red, brown, and blue. The fashion of Regencycore consists of a lot of heavy inspiration taken from the era itself. For example, back in the day, stays became an undergarment rather than being placed on top of a dress. If opting for a more masculine appearance, wear trousers with a button-up or a cravat shirt, and a blazer suit or a tailcoat on top, depending on how modern you want to look. Add in some polished shoes and a top hat if you wish. Accessorize with a pocket watch and a walking stick if you'd like. It was common in this era for men to have medium to long length hair and sideburns, often with a Titus haircut. If you wish to modernize this look, opt for a frilled shirt and perhaps add a vest on top and pair it with some neutral colored trousers. For a more feminine appearance, choose an empire waistcoat dress. Underneath it, wear a corset, stay, or other lingerie. Add a bonnet, some elbow-length silk gloves, and a long coat if necessary. Add some heeled shoes or decorative flats to complete the look. For a more modern version, you can choose the empire waistcoat in a simpler, flowery dress, perhaps of a different length too. You could replace the bonnet with your hair pinned up in a bun and decorate it with some hair accessories, such as ribbons and floral decorations. You could choose to wear your hair as it is naturally and decorate it with a few ornamental pieces if you'd like. For makeup, less is more, and similar shades are key. Use natural colors of red and pink for your blush and lipstick. Basically, this is like the no makeup makeup look, very natural but has a little something to it. And that's it for this aesthetic video. I wish you all the best with your journey in fashion, and please do not forget to like and subscribe for the algorithm. Let me know in the comments what aesthetic you'd like me to do next, and I'll see you next time.